Earthbox and Skystriker, probably two of my more interesting rogue decks. This is the top 16 from the PPG. Be like those 36.5% of you that just have not hit that subscribe button. Come on, smash it today so we can get to 100K. All right, so what is going on over here with the meta? All right, between the breakdown coverage that you watched this morning and this, it tells me that Rogue has a very viable chance for now. So this is top 16 Earth Toolbox, and we've seen Earthbox for quite some time here, doing wonderful things in the format. The trap card interruptions here, you know, the urgent schedule for the good place to generate a board. This deck really does cool things through its link one, but it still has like missing pieces. It's still a very combo oriented combo deck. If they had something to make them a little bit more streamlined, they'd have a higher chance of doing things. But unfortunately, you know, we can't even really fit in Crossout Designator because you're already at 42 cards, and unless you're going to cut something like Skullmeister, I don't foresee it going very well. So we have one Ancient Gearbox, my favorite brick, two copies of Artifact Lancia, two copies of Ash Blossom and Joy Spring, triple copies of Effect Veiler, one copy of the Heavy Freight Train Derecrane, one copy of Anchor Drill, triple copies of the Brutal Dozer, triple copies of Harvester, one copy of the Trencher, one copy of the Tunneler, one Citadel, one Fortress, the Triple Metal Cruncher, of course, triple copies of Skullmeister, one copy of the Bullet Train, triple copies of Heavy Forward, triple copies of Machina Redeployment, two copies of the old Revolving Switchyard. Now, this is actually kind of interesting. I've not seen any of these builds trying this out right now. I do think that this does give an interesting dynamic to this deck, though, because the whole Earth box that it's had going for extenders, you know, from, let's be honest here, so you get, like, extending options. Yeah, it's really what I care about, extending options, actually. I don't know. This just is a consistenter way to get to the good card. Okay, so we have two copies of Urgent Schedule. Interesting to see two of this and not three of it, but I can understand why. Triple copies of Infinite Permanence and two copies of Machina Overdrive. Then we have one copy of Clefor Genius, triple copies of Goliath, one copy of the Double Angler, one Ballista, with one Juggernaut Libby, the one Gustav, the one Inner Blafnir, the one Superdora, one Riverstormer, the one copy of the Earth Slifer, one Girgigant, one Zeus, and the one Dingrisu. And then we have two copies of Psychorator, two Drawn Knockbird, two Nibiru, two copies of Twin Twisters, triple copies of Anti-Spell Fragrance, triple copies of Evenly Matched, and one copy of Imperial Order here. Wrapping up, yes, ladies and gentlemen, yes, Earthbox. There's really nothing else to say about this. To me, all of these decks kind of look the same, and I don't mean to say that in, like, a bad way, but Earthbox, like, I feel a lot of the ratios are pretty standardized by everybody that picks this deck up and gives it a shot. All right, next up here is, yes, my other favorite deck. This is Invoked Dogmatica Eldritch? So we are doing some real weird shenanigans here. Alright, we're taking advantage of the Eld Elixir package here, and we are going to laugh at the opponent as we climb up and do what we do best. Yeah, good times. Seeing this package in this deck is such a small subdivision of this deck. Is so weird. So we have one copy of Psyframe Driver, two copies of Eldritch, the Golden Lord, one copy of Dogmatica Fleur-de-Lis, one Maximus, one copy of Ecclesia, triple copies of Alistair, the plus one Invoker, triple copies of Gamma. That's it. That's your monster lineup. We're not doing anything else too crazy here. We have triple copies of Nidir Servant, triple copies of Triple Tactics Talents, one copy of Terraforming, two Invocation, one copy of Prosperity, triple copies of Forbidden Droplet, triple copies of Cursed Eldland, triple copies of Magical Meltdown, and then our trap board here is triple Scarlet, one Punishment, triple Conk, one copy of Schism, and one copy of Haguero. Down here in the extra deck, we have one Almirage, the one Secure Gardener, the one Cross Sheep, the one Unicorn, the one Access Code, the one Omega, with two Anintis, one copy of Winda, one copy of Apicalone, one Algoides, one Titanclad, one Construct, and two copies of Makaba. Side deck here, we have two Nibiru, one Pankratops, two Phantasme, two Drone Lockbird, two Cosmic Cyclone, two Summon Limit, one IO, and triple copies of Solemn Judgment here. wrapping up a hybrid package of good defense, good offensive capabilities, I guess if you really want to call it that. I'm also very shocked to see that Maximus is seeing play here. I do believe that the format has shifted far enough away that most people will be playing in Intus here, so you should get some free chicken tendy value off of this. But honestly, I'm also glad to see that we're back. Because we are playing this, you do have to play the Almirage Gardener here because it gives you easier access to this. Now, technically, if you want to get super cheesy, because you are playing the Almirage here, you can put back in Mr. Attack Everything on the opponent's field guide, but just more options for you at the end of the day. Next up here is frickin' Sky Striker. Ah, yes, I remember everybody crying their little britches off because the infamous Engage came back to one. You guys remember when everybody was crying on the internet about this? Yeah, I remember. And then the deck just fell off. Alright, it's sad to say, but another exaggeration of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community? Check. Alright, so we have triple copies of Ash Blossom and Joy Spring, triple copies of Effect Veiler, triple copies of Ghost Bow, and triple copies of Nibiru, and triple copies of Skullmeister. That's... Oh, and we'll just make the note here of triple Imprint. That is 18 hand traps built into this stupid deck, just to make sure that whatever you are going to deal with across the table... It won't bother you at all. If you really want to know what modern Yu-Gi-Oh! Is like, this right here. Good one-card engines and a whole hell of a lot of hand traps to not let your opponent have a good time. All right? And then, of course, we have triple Ray, two rows. Do not, for the love of God, try to play multiple rows. All right? Do not try to play three of this card. Every build that I've seen play three of this has not had a good time overall. And I'm not saying that... It's just, you're too much Sky Striker. Alright? We also have one Called by the Grave. Triple copies of Potter's Desires. Is that why we're playing so many hand traps? We go first. We get to our combo pieces. Slap Desires on the table. Draw hand traps. Like, I guess. One Rota. One Area Zero. One Afterburners. One Eagle Booster. One Hornet Drones. Two Shark Cannon. Triple Widow Anchor. The one multi-roll. The one Engage. And the one Upstart Goblin here. Wrapping up the main deck here. Down in the next deck, we have one Zeke. Triple Shizuku. One Kaina. Triple Kagari. Two Hayate. I've noticed that most of these decks at this point just rely on the two Hayate. We have one Selene. The one Ningrisu. One Nightmare Phoenix. The one Hulk. And the one Axis Machine. Side deck here, we have triple Ancia, triple Cosmic Cyclone, triple MST, triple Shared Ride, and triple Dimensional Barrier. Whew! I'm glad to see that we are really ahead of our time on this one. And then the last list I have for you guys, this is Sean Pittman's top 16, really saucy Phantom Knight list, actually. We are packing the crossout designators down here in the side deck, which will help us round out some of our matchups we need them. Because not every matchup will be crossout designator friendly. So we have triple copies of Ash Blossom and Joy Spring. One Seer, one Jackalope, one Tsuchinoko, two Effect Veiler, one Ghost Ogre, one copy Graf, triple copies of Junk Fort, two Kage Musha, triple copies of Nibiru, one Psychic Tracker with one Psychic Wielder, one Sangen, two copies of Cloak, one copy of Ragged Gloves, two Silent Boots, triple Torn Scales, triple Tour Guide, with one Dark Magician, and one Red Eyes Black Dragon. Side deck here, spells, we have one Called by the Grave, two Emergency Teleport, one Foolish Barrel, triple Forbidden Droplet, one Red Ice Fusion, one Rota, triple Tactics Talents, triple. We have triple copies of Fogblade and one Shade Brigadier. Extra deck down, we have one Rusty Tin Can, one Almirage, the one Verte, one Link Spider with the one Nightmare Unicorn, one Phoenix, one copy of IP, one Cherubini, one Access Code, two copies of Phantom Knight's Break Sword, one Levier, one Downard, one Zeus, and one copy of Dark Dragoon. Side deck here, we have triple Ally of Justice Cycle Reader, one Lancia, triple copies of Crossout Designer, triple Twin Twisters, triple copies of Gozen Match, one copy of Imperial Order, and one copy of Red Reboot here, wrapping up this chunk of deck profiles out of this weekend's PPG Case Tournament. So, format, new, exciting, interesting stuff. Yeah, there's all kinds of cool ideas, all the way from like the top meta decks evolving. You have a game-changing set on the way here. Hi, Burst of Destiny. Can't wait to see you in a month. Just take hold of the metagame and shake it up crazily. So guys, what do you think about these lists? Please, leave a comment down below, tell me what you guys think, and I'll see your beautiful faces back here later on in the day with some more cool content. Don't forget to smash over the crypto, that's the script. Peace out, guys. Have a good one. Thank you, patrons, for making the ride never truly end. Without you guys' support, well, I would probably be doing Truffle Shuffle videos for a living. Guys, please check out VanCole 40 for all of your Cardfight Vanguard content brought to you by VanCole 40. And if you are looking to pick up singles, check out mcolegames.com for your trading card game needs. Thanks for watching, everybody.